When?
Hey, I'm Aaron with Truewood Design, and I'm working on this carving. I'm doing a couple humpback whales, and they are going to be part of a console table that's going at the entryway to a house. And the console table is back here in my shipping container. And this is all Techie Cypress with black resin inlay on it. And the whale carving that I'm doing is going to get mounted floating under the table with metal rods holding it 2 inches off each side. The reason I went with Techie Cypress on this is because the client that I'm building the table for has some artwork that goes on the wall above it. And it's kind of beachy artwork. And so I brought up the idea of doing Techie Cypress because it's kind of beachy and weathered, and it's going to go really nice with the artwork that's going above it. And the guy also has a thing for whales, and we're doing this carving of the humpback whales to go underneath it, and it's all going to tie in really well together. One of the things I did, or that I'm working on doing, is for the carving that's going to be floating underneath here, instead of doing Techie Cypress, I'm doing Cypress, because I can't have all the voids in there to do a carving. It wouldn't look good. And then I'm also, on the carving you'll see in a second, I did a frame. I'm carving a frame around it because the whales and the water behind it is going to be a really organic shape, flowing. But then the table is squared off. So to go from a piece of artwork that's flowing and organic to a square table, I feel like would look like they're just thrown together. But by doing a carving a frame around it, it's going from the organic shape into a frame, into this frame table. And so I think it'll all go together. But we're gonna work today with a tool that's one of my favorites. It's called the Sir Lancelot, or the Lancelot, by King Arthur Tools. And it's like having a little handheld chainsaw. It's a chainsaw attachment, basically, for your angle grinder. And that is right here. And so, if you look closely at it, it's a chain, just like that goes in the chainsaw, only it's small, and it's really sharp and really dangerous, and I always leave the safety guard on, because I have a friend out in Colorado, he knows who he is, that had the guard off of there, and he was working with it, and it caught, and he cut his hand up pretty good. And I don't want to do that. So I always keep both hands on the tool, and I always keep the chain guard on there. A couple things when using this tool is it's good for going side to side. You could cut side to side with it, but when you're cutting side to side, you could only go as deep as the cutter's on here. If you go deeper than that and try and go to the side, it won't work. And of course, since it's spinning this way, the tool wants to pull away from it. So when I'm carving, I get a good hold on it, and I do small passes side to side, but it's great for removing a lot of material. And with this whale carving I'm doing, I'm getting rid of all this background material. I'm going to do a relief carving. And after all that material is removed, I'm going to start shaping the flow of the water and then also adding more detail to the whale. But you can see I already outlined a frame. And then I'm going to have parts of the whale come out over the frame, so it really looks like it's popping out at you. And I think after I get going on this, Amber's going to take over and try doing some carving too. So.
spend much time thinking about the water here. Luckily,